Hello, Classic Crew, and welcome to today's video where we're going to be talking about 5 ways to be a better wife. Being a better wife is so important because it's about being a good partner to the man that you love. When you meet the man that you want to marry, there's a lot of it that's just fun and easy and, oh, you enjoy spending time together, oh, you have kind of ideas for your future, but there are certain things you really can do to be a better partner and to be kind of more intentional in the way that you treat your spouse. And I do want to address that I'm planning on doing a video on 5 ways to be a better husband as well, but all of this is obviously based on the idea that you're both doing your best to be a good spouse. It's not just about one person being better and the other one not improving. It's not just about women being good wives while men don't have to do anything. Both partners really have to put in the time and effort to be the best spouse to the person that they love. And of course, that's what you want to do when you get married. You want to be good to the person that loves you and who you love. This shouldn't be a huge ask for you to actually want to be better and give a better life to your partner, because if you are keeping them in mind, then they're going to have a better life. And the same goes for you. Hopefully they're going to be keeping you in mind as well. I would assume that's the case if you chose to marry them. So I'm really excited to get into 5 tips for being a better wife. So let's get into it. My first tip is a basic one, and that is communicate. I find that with myself, there's sort of a tendency to have an imaginary version of things where you think that, oh, I'm gonna walk in the house and I'm gonna have a new dress on and my hair is gonna be done and my husband is definitely going to notice. And then as soon as he doesn't, you're disappointed. Or if you clean the house and you put in a lot of effort and your husband isn't necessarily the type to notice clutter in the first place, he may not necessarily notice, and you've imagined this scenario where he comes in and he thinks, wow, oh my gosh, it's amazing, and he gives you a big hug and a kiss, and maybe he just doesn't notice, and again, you're disappointed. Your husband can't read your mind, and it's not fair to ask him to try. It's okay to give him an idea of things that you'd like him to recognize in the future, but asking him to read your mind without any sort of guidance is just unfair, and it's only going to be a breeding ground for arguments. So the haircut and the dress thing, I think that that's a little bit hard. You can't kind of say hard and fast rule, I want you to notice when I get my hair done, because how would he know? But the idea of, okay, when you come home, if you notice that the house is clean, I would love it if you recognized it and you gave me a big hug and you thanked me. You know, that kind of thing. Just giving him some guidance about what would make you happy, because that's what he wants. He wants to make you happy. And then even more than that, you should always tell him what you feel when you're feeling it. In the sense of, if he upsets you, if he does something that upsets you, don't let that just percolate and become worse over time. Immediately bring it up and immediately tell him that he did something that upset you. Because if you do bring it up as it happens, you're not going to be letting it build up, and then all of a sudden, all of these emotions come to the surface and the communication just totally breaks down. If you bring it up in the moment, then you'll be able to actually have that conversation more calmly, and you'll actually get more accomplished because he'll be able to hear you rather than trying to sort through kind of all of the emotions that you're throwing at him. He'll be able to hear why you're upset, not that you're upset, if that makes sense. And what goes into this is, don't let your emotions run away with you, because the fact of the matter is, you should know that your husband loves you. That's why you married him, that's why he married you. So if you always keep that in mind, then even when he upsets you, you're not going to think that he did that for a malicious reason, that he doesn't like you and he wants to hurt your feelings. He may have done something unthinking. He may have done something that he didn't mean to do, or that he hurt you without even realizing. And so you realizing that, okay, that wasn't coming from a malicious place, that was most likely accidental, then you can actually be more calm about the whole scenario and you can still approach it from a place of love, and the communication is still very strong. Always giving your husband the benefit of the doubt will prevent tension from building up between you. So keeping the lines of communication open is incredibly important. Being open about what you want, addressing situations as they come up, telling him when he's upset you. But what goes hand in hand with this is also the idea of how you communicate, not getting overworked or over emotional so that he can hear why you're upset, not just that you're upset. Number 2 is respect your husband even if you disagree. You and your husband are going to disagree at a lot of points during your marriage. It's just normal. It's going to happen, even if it's not really frequently, it's going to happen at least sometimes. But disrespecting your husband when you get into a disagreement is never okay, and it's not going to be good for your relationship. And it's not a good way to treat each other. You wouldn't want him to treat you with disrespect. So if you are going to be disrespectful to him, that's also unfair, and it's not something that breeds love. But it is very important for men to feel respected, that their wives respect everything about what they do and who they are and how they think, their intelligence. And undermining that for just a petty disagreement, it's just never going to be good for your marriage. It's so important to show that you can disagree and still respect the other person, because you can disagree with an idea while still respecting the person who had that idea. And the fact of the matter is, you do respect your husband. Again, that's part of the reason that you married him. So if you respect your husband and you do respect his opinions generally, even in a disagreement, just keeping in mind that the disagreement is something that the two of you are working against, not you two working against each other. And that is going to really kind of keep in your head that you don't disrespect him, that he doesn't disrespect you, that you have this disagreement that the two of you are working together to resolve. Number three is show him love in the way that he receives it, not in the way that you want to give it. So this idea is based on a book called The Five Love Languages. I absolutely love that book. I read it in high school and I was fascinated. I loved the whole idea. I think I actually had my whole family read it too because I just thought it was so interesting. And the idea is that we all communicate in five different love languages. We have quality time, words of affirmation, acts of service, gifts, and physical touch. And we all have a couple primary ones or just one primary one. And usually the way that you receive love is also the way that you give love. So if you receive love, if you feel loved when someone gives you quality time, when somebody turns off their phone and just sits with you and spends some really directed time with you, then that's how you're going to give love. You're going to think, okay, this person wants me to spend time with them, very directed time. I'm not going to be doing anything else. But that person who you love may not receive love the same way that you do. And that's kind of an interesting thing to work with, right? If you are somebody who receives love as quality time and the person that you've married receives love as gifts, then when you're trying to give them quality time, they'll like it, but they're not necessarily going to feel like their cup is filled with love. Whereas if you buy them something that's really meaningful, then they may. So trying to figure out how your husband receives love is going to make your relationship even better. For me, my husband and I are pretty lucky because both of us, I think our top love language is quality time. So we enjoy spending time with each other and that is how we both feel loved. But our secondary one I think is different. I would say mine is physical touch. I like when he has his arm around me while we're watching a movie. So sometimes I'll give him physical touch in a moment where I would want physical touch. And he doesn't mind it, he likes it, but it's not the same way that he would receive love. So figuring out what your husband wants and how he receives love will just make your relationship so much more fresh. Number four is always make your husband feel loved and respected when the two of you are around other people. Have you ever been at a dinner or a lunch where a husband and wife are there and that wife is constantly kind of poking fun at her husband and making fun of her husband or complaining about him while he's right there? It's very uncomfortable. It's happened to me many times. I'm sure it's happened to you at least once or twice in your life. And there's always this feeling of, is this appropriate? Or should we laugh? What do we do here? And it's never a good idea to put your husband down in front of other people. It just isn't nice. It's not something that makes your relationship better. Can you like tease a little bit if you're out with another couple who's kind of in your same stage of life and it's just kind of funny? I think that's okay in the same way that he can tease you a little bit, right? So if you kind of make a joke, oh, my husband always puts his clothes next to the hamper, not in them, and your girlfriend and her husband laugh and agree because he does it too, I think that's okay. In the same way that if your husband kind of said, oh yeah, Abby always takes an extra 15 minutes to do her hair and makeup or something like that. Yeah, okay, that's okay, because it's relatable. You're relating to each other. But if you're constantly saying, yeah, my husband is always late, my husband never does the dishes, something just mean, where you're just directing attention to his negative aspects, just bringing your problems out in the open, airing them in front of other people, it's rude to him and it's really disrespectful and it's not good for your marriage. If you guys have problems, these are the problems you need to deal with. at home. You need to talk to each other about it and really fix it and work on it, because this, I'm sure that's not the kind of relationship that you want, where people think that maybe you don't get along as well as you do. And if these are issues that are coming up in front of other people, then they're probably things that you didn't communicate about, rule number one, early on. And so being the kind of wife that your husband feels really excited to bring around other people because he knows that you're going to reflect well on him, that is just so good for a marriage. And you always want to be the kind of wife that maybe an unmarried man would look at and say, wow, I'd really like to be with a woman who loves and respects me the way she respects her husband. I mean, that's just always going to make your husband feel really good and loved and make your marriage even better. In the same way that he should make you feel beautiful and loved when the two of you are out together. Number five is a little bit of a lighter one, and that's figure out the chores that each of you likes and dislikes and make it work between you. So for example, I hate taking out the trash. I hate it. I hate it forever. And Jacob doesn't really mind. He doesn't love it. It's not his least favorite thing to do. He takes out the garbage every week. That's our agreement. You do the garbage and I'll take care of some other chores that you don't like. He really doesn't like doing the dishes. We've discovered this in the last year. Initially, we thought, okay, you'll do the dishes, we'll divide it up, but that's a chore he actually really doesn't like doing. He hates washing pots specifically. Fair enough, washing pots is very frustrating. It's kind of unwieldy. So I said to him, you know what? Washing pots and pans really doesn't bother me all that much. I don't mind doing it. I'll do the dishes and you take out the trash. And of course there are other many chores in the house that the two of us divide. But that's a good example of something where don't force it just because it has to be a certain way, right? A lot of the time people will say that the wife has to cook dinner and the husband has to wash dishes. Jacob doesn't like washing dishes. That's totally fine with me. I don't mind washing dishes. It really doesn't bother me at all. I really don't like taking out the garbage. Jacob doesn't mind. He'll do it. You know, that works out for us. So figuring out what chores each one of you despises so that the other person can take it over. Because generally, you're not going to find a chore that you absolutely love to do. And you'll say, okay, I'm only going to do the chores that I love, because people don't love chores. That's why they're chores. But there are chores that you will specifically hate. And so figuring out what those are so that you don't have to do them and the other person doesn't mind works out. So that's it for my five tips to be a better wife. Let me know in the comments if you guys have any other tips that you'd like to share with us. I'd love to hear. Thank you guys so much for watching today's video. Please subscribe to my channel and blog if you haven't already. Head over to my Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook and follow me there. Hit that notification bell to get notified of all my new videos. Hit that like button. Please head over to classicallyabby.locals.com if you'd like to support my channel, see more of this content, and be part of our community. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!